Hello friends, so in this video we are going to solve this question. So the question is, Warren Buffett is an enormously wealthy investor who has built his fortune through his legendary investing acumen. He currently has been offers three major investments and he would like to choose one. So there are three options that he have, and out of these three options he just want to choose only one option. The first one is a conservative investment and would perform very well in an improving economy and only suffer a small loss in an worsening economy. The second is a speculative investment that would perform exactly well in an improving economy and would do very badly in an worsening economy. The third is a counter cyclical investment that would lose some money in an improving economy but would perform well in worsening economy. Warren believes that there are three possible scenarios over the lives of these potential investments: an improving economy, a stable economy, and worsening economy. So since as we know that this investment, this return, return of investment or the return of interest or the interest rate, so these are all depend upon the health of economy also. So according to this question, there are three types of economy: improving economy, stable economy, and worsening economy. And okay, so he also estimate that profits under these respective scenarios are those given by following table. So under conservative investment, so if the economy status is improving, then the profit or the return actually is 30 million. And for the same investment, if the economy is stable, that means the economy is stable economy, then the profit is 5 million. Actually, it is not profit, but it is return. So, and for the worsening economy, the same investment would be cost 10 million return. So, determine which investment should Warren make under each of the following criteria. So, criterion of optimism, Hurwitz criterion, and Laplace criterion. So, this is a question of typical decision theory where we need to apply our concepts and have to solve this question by these three, these three methods. So I have already solved this question by this presentation one. So this is the file this is the path where my file is located. Let's do the question. So I have written the table. I have drawn the table the same. However, I just reshaped my this economy in this column and all the other investments in this row. So hope you can understand, everything is same, I just reshaped. Now for criterion of optimism, so as we know that our optimism, under the optimism criteria, we choose the maximax criteria or the maximum return that we choose. So for this, we just need to find the maximum value of each investment. So we just need to create a set. So here we created a set. So first we need to find the maximum value of each investment. So for first investment, the maximum value would be 30 million dollar. So I just here I just written 30. Then for speculative, that would be $40 million, and for counter cyclical, it would be zero. So here I created a set of 30, 40, and 0. So under optimism, the value would be of this x would be maximax of x, which is the maximum value of this set, which is $40 million. So he should invest in speculative investment. So as per the optimism criteria is concerned, then he should invest in speculative investment, since speculative investment is giving the highest return. So now let's do the Hurwitz criterion. What Hurwitz criterion actually is? So Hurwitz criterion is nothing but Hurwitz is none but a very well-known scientist or statistician who invented this criteria. So according to him, so every person has some amount of optimism and some amount of pessimism. some amount of optimism and some amount of pessimism. So under uncertainty, this optimism, pessimism, rationality, these all factors come. So according to Hurwitz, every person has some amount of optimism and some amount of pessimism. So here the alpha value is already given, and the alpha value means nothing but the coefficient of your optimism, and 1 minus alpha is nothing but the coefficient of your pessimism. So under this criteria, so let's draw something. Also under this criteria, the return will be for conservative investment alpha into maximum return plus 1 minus alpha into minimum return. So here I need to go to the table. So here so it's a matrix actually. So alpha into maximum return of conservative and plus 1 minus alpha, which is 0.15, into minimum return of the company, which is minus 10. So here we need to just add this thing, and the number of column, so here the number of column may be n number of columns would be there. So 4, 5, 6, 7, 10, 20, anything can be possible. So for each column you will be getting a Hurwitz, you'll be getting a Hurwitz value. So this value is called the Hurwitz value. Here we have calculated the Hurwitz value. Now we need to create a set of this each Hurwitz value, and have to find the maximum value. So here the maximum value is $29.5 million. So he should invest in speculative since the return is highest. Now if we go to the third question, the Laplace criterion. So Laplace criterion is nothing but there would be some there would be a probability attached with every investment. So the probability would be very simple. The probability would be, you know, the frequency distribution, which is nothing but the 1 by number of observation n. So 1 by n would be the probability, and it would be, you know, these are equilikely event. So 1 by 3 would be there until and unless you have the probability is given to you. So you need to just calculate the frequency distribution. So here 1/3. So how did you get this? So under conservative investment, so the probability is attached is 1/3. So 1/3 into 30 plus 1/3 into 5 minus 1/3 into 10/3. So this is the value of payoff. This is the payoff value under conservative investment. And in same way, we have calculated we have calculated for the 6.67, and cyclical we have calculated the 1.667. So we are seeing that the conservative is giving the highest return here. So he should invest in conservative investment. So thank you. I think you understood the concept. Bye bye.